Today we'll be going over 7 things that fans want in GTA 6. We want a return to Vice City. GTA Vice City is still a true fan favorite for many GTA devotees. Its melodious soundtrack, crazy characters, and memorable missions have endeared it to many fans over a decade later. However, it is Vice City itself, a reimagining of 1980s Miami, that's the game star's attraction. As the only city not to be revisited since the 6th console generation, we'd love a return to Vice City back in the hedonistic 80s, in the present day, as one of the multiple cities or a brief cameo, it's been long overdue. We want single-player DLC. The absence of single-player DLC in GTA 5 was a disappointing, especially considering both the first Red Dead and GTA 4 had it. Episodes from Liberty City was a particular fan favorite, with many players actually preferring the 2 additional episodes more than the main game, especially the Battle of Gay Tony. They served as a nice contract to the main game while expanding on and tying up loose ends within the already stellar story. It'd be a missed opportunity if Rockstar didn't include it in GTA 6. Heartbreaking, savvy, and loving's a bitch. We want better hand-to-hand combat. We've already alluded to our desire to be able to learn new fighting moves as part of a more broad-reaching character customization suite. That being said, if we could not learn how to execute a single leg or thrown axe kick, we still need better hand-to-hand combat than we saw in GTA 5. It was sluggish and one-dimensional, with NPCs that were too easy to knock out while totally getting rid of the counters and varied combat of GTA 4. In GTA 6, we want to return to the combat of San Andreas and GTA 4. We want destructible environments. A totally destructible world is never going to be feasible in a GTA game. After all, contained within the sprawling metropolises are employers, shops, and safe houses that need to remain standing for the game to function correctly. However, some destructible architecture, especially if GTA 6 is going to be exclusively next-gen, would be fitting and would add a new level of realism to the series. We saw hints of this in GTA 5 when Michael tore down Madrazo's paramour's house. Now we just need that on a more macro scale. We want more interiors. To be fair, when you're an open-world sandbox game set in a city with thousands of buildings, access to all of them just isn't feasible. The only thing we would ask is that Rockstar keep building upon the increasing detail and grant player access with each new installment in the series. Obviously, titles like Red Dead and The Witcher have a higher percentage of buildings you can enter, but that's only because they have far fewer in total. As long as GTA 6 progresses from 5, we'll be satisfied. We want contested territory. One of the most unique features in San Andreas when compared to the rest of the series was contested territory. At any time during the game, one of your areas could come under attack and you would have to defend it. You could also go to neutral or enemy territory and fight to take it over. There are similar elements in Red Dead Redemption 2 where bounties and rival gang presence can make traversing through certain areas harder. A similar feature in GTA 6 would make the game more tense, entertaining, and make the world feel more alive and reactive. We want an iconic soundtrack. There are fewer games better known or more defined by its music than Grand Theft Auto, with the last 2 GTA titles having undeniably great soundtracks. However, when it comes to iconic tracks that suited the games perfectly, Vice City and San Andreas are untouchable. Out of Touch was a perfect representation of 1980s Vice City, and Nothing But a G-Fang was perfect for 1990s East Santos. Both enhanced the game to no end. GTA 6 will no doubt have an epic soundtrack. We just hope it's as iconic as those PS2 classics. That's going to do it for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like on the video, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any of our videos in the future. I'll catch you next time. Goodbye.